Look at what I pulled out of my eyeball. In case you haven't already guessed it, this video is going to be about eye protection. So if you're squeamish, you don't want to hear the story, there's really nothing to see on my eye, that spoiler alert. I'll show it to you, but if you're squeamish, you might want to skip ahead. So I was on a job and working inside, had safety glasses on earlier in the day. We were inside, we're cleaning up, just about done, and needed a couple more nails and one section interior framing. And I was using a coilated nail gun. Those coilated nail guns have nails that are in a big coil, and they use these two copper strands of wire to hold the packs of nails together. And that wire is designed to break and shear off, and it did just that. And a piece of this copper wire went flying and caught me right in the eyeball. And at first, it was like, you know, just a little impact. Like, you get wood chips and everything else. I've never been a big safety guy, and I've dodged many bullets. In fact, I had an eye injury when I was a kid that almost took out an eye from a bungee cord. But anyway, I should have learned my lesson then. I knew better, should have had safety glasses on. But again, it's dark, fogged up, can't see, take the safety glasses off, doing your thing. Well, this piece was sticking out on my eyeball, and it was catching my eyelid, and every time I would blink, it was, you know, gouging into my eye. And just in the heat of the moment, luckily one of the guys on the job had a pair of tweezers. I went to the truck mirror, grabbed a hold of that sucker, pulled on it, and I could only see like the very end of this piece. I couldn't really tell that it was that. If I knew it was that long, I would not have pulled it out of my eyeball. I kind of knew that was not the right thing to do. But I pulled on it, and it came a little bit, and I pulled on it some more, and then this sucker came out, bunch of blood, liquid behind it, and I started to lose vision, get blurred vision in that eye almost right away. So that was pretty nasty. Went to the ER. I don't know if the ER doctor really thought that I was exaggerating or if he just wasn't listening, but they looked at it, put some dye in it, made sure there were no other metal fragments in there, and like, here's some antibiotic eye drops, you'll be fine. Well, vision didn't come back, and I went in for a follow-up on that following Monday, and they told me that this piece of copper actually made contact with the lens, caused a cataract, and now I'm looking at eye surgery. So I can't see much out of this eye at all. So if you're curious to see what it looks like, patch off. All right, I don't know how well you'll be able to see in the camera lens, but the big old black spot of iris missing. That's actually a hole in my eye where, you know, light can get in. I don't have double vision, but there's a chance I could have, I guess. That spot is not from this injury. That's actually from that bungee cord I was talking about when I was a kid. So, but this little piece landed in that exact same spot. So I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, but they're gonna have to, when they go in and do surgery, I don't know if they're gonna address that issue. I definitely should have learned my lesson the first time. That makes three eye injuries I've had in my lifetime, and I still have two good eyeballs. Well, I will have when they operate on this one. So it's extremely lucky that they're gonna be able to do surgery on this eye. I could definitely be going the rest of my life with one eyeball. So moral of the story is wear your damn safety glasses. And on that note, I'm gonna go over a couple different pairs of safety glasses that I picked up, specifically looking for like anti-fog, comfort anti-fog, because that's the big thing. Sweat and fog, and it's just the humidity when you're working, it makes them impractical to wear, and then they cloud up, you can't see anything, and you injure yourself some other way because you can't see what you're doing. So let's take a look at that. All right, in this lineup we have a new pair of Milwaukee fog-free lenses, so we'll see about that. It's really my main complaint with any of them is fog. This is pair of DeWalt. They're more like goggles. So these are about 10 or 15 bucks on Amazon. These are about 20, 25 on Amazon. So I'll check this style out. I have a feeling they're gonna fog up pretty bad. They've got vent holes in the top, but
I have a feeling they are going to fog up a lot because there's not a lot of ventilation around there. Then this pair I've had for a while, they're made by 3M. They've got the foam around them. These are super comfy, probably my favorite pair. These are the pair I had on earlier in the day, but was not actually wearing them at the time of the incident. Then just a pair of cheapies. These yellow lenses, though, I found actually work pretty good indoors. And I may have opted for this if I had them on the truck that day instead, because like I said, we were working inside in low light conditions. It was tough to see. And then this is just a couple empty cases. I think it's important to point out, keeping your safety glasses in a case will help you keep track of them, because I'm bad about losing stuff, and it will keep them from getting scratched up and ruined. As if they're scratched, you can't see, you're not gonna wear them. So the first thing I want to test is right out of the box, how well do these things hold up with fog? So I got my trusty Sunbeam here. Set that thing to full steam ahead. These are brand new, obviously. I've never put any kind of treatment on these other lenses. I've just cleaned them with alcohol or, you know, whatever, hand sanitizer, whatever I had at the time if they needed to be cleaned. But these fog up pretty bad, even with the little ventilation that it does have around them. They already fog up pretty bad as it is. Oh yeah. Ooh. All right.
All right, here we go, 3Ms. Very nice, very comfortable. I like the right size for my face, and everyone's face is a little bit different, but overall impression, first impression's pretty good. They are super, super clear. Of course, they're brand new, super clear, and pretty impressed with how well they performed. Not a whole lot of steam stuck to them, so these might stand a chance. Even steaming that thing up and then putting them on my face, like, almost clears up on its own. That's not very humid today, so I don't know if that's a fair assessment, because that'll make a big difference. So, I mean, surprisingly anti-fog. I was a skeptic, but I mean, I'm really having to blast them with the iron to get any fog at all to stick to them. And when it does, I mean, I'm pretty much just shooting water at them. When it does, it's gone right away. So these may become my new favorite pair. We'll test them out in the field and see. All right, DeWalt's. I have to adjust the strap a little bit. Go skiing. There we go. Yeah, these, I don't know if I could handle wearing these all day. I feel like that would sweat against your face almost instantly. And probably you'd be like wearing a set of dive goggles when you're trying to work. Very clear, also pretty comfy. So there's a nice good shot of steam on it. Not too bad. Of course, I can only see out of one eye right now, so not too bad. I feel like there's more ventilation around them than I thought. That seal, that rubber seal, is already hot, like, against my skin. So I feel like that would sweat, especially if you're doing any kind of activity at all. You're gonna sweat. It's just like a silicone. There's no foam or anything right there. So that might be a deal killer for these. Not so sure I could handle those all day long. And now that I'm looking at it, there is more ventilation on the bottom here. So these might stand a chance. They are pretty comfy. And of course, you know, this is gonna have an application where safety glasses don't. But obviously all these I will wear on the job, real world application, try them out for a couple weeks and update the feedback. All right, these from 3M I've had for a while. I bought them because they've got foam around them. They're probably my favorite pair. No, I haven't given the others a fair test drive yet, but I've had these for a while. And the only major complaint I can say is that they do fog real bad. There's not enough ventilation with the foam, and all the heat coming off your face just gets trapped in there and they fog real bad. So on a humid day, you could literally every 60 seconds I can take them off, wipe them, put them back on. They fog up again. And that's why I wasn't wearing them, you know, when I took a piece of metal to the eye, because it's that exact same scenario. You know, 60 seconds, stop what you're doing, take safety glasses off, wipe them, put them back on. It's just not practical, you know? Well, neither is using one eyeball for the rest of your life either, so. Yeah, just like one little light mist with that iron, and you can see how much fog is behind it, and it's not going anywhere. Like, it's starting to clear up, but it's not very humid today. It's actually pretty dry, so on a humid day, no dice. Well, the only other complaint I would have about these is the way they're shaped, and this end kind of digs into the back of your head. I get like, I don't know, a knot or blood vessels or something back there that just don't agree with the way these fit my face. And if I wear them too long, then they'll start to give me a headache. So everybody's gonna be different on that. It may not irritate you, or another pair may irritate you, or they wouldn't someone else, so. All right, now I don't know who made these, but they're just a cheapy pair. They don't even have, I don't even see a brand on them. But I had these for a long time too. I specifically just wanted to try something with a yellow lens. I like the yellow. I haven't really worn these, and just digging them out of the toolbox. I'm kind of wondering why I haven't worn them more often, especially in low light conditions. I feel like these probably would have been the thing to have that day that the incident occurred, because it does help to have that yellow filter just in the shop here. It's not dark or anything, but it does kind of help just to have that yellow lens. Oh, nice little shot of fog. Cleared up quickly. Fast forward a minute or two, I have been using these almost every day on the job, the Milwaukees, and I really like them. They are hands down the winner. They've been sweat on, I've cleaned them a bunch. They had all kinds of, you know, sawdust and gravel dust and everything else on them. And they're still holding up pretty decent to the anti-fog properties that they brag about. And now with all this COVID-19 stuff, I've been wearing a mask almost every day too, depending on where I'm at. And still get a little bit of, you know, breath come around, and especially if I'm wearing a hat, they will still fog a little bit. But night and day compared to like the 3Ms or even the colored lenses that I have. Now, these DeWalt goggles, really shouldn't even put them in the same category, to be honest, because they're a different tool. These are great for when you need them, when you need goggles, you're grinding, you're spraying or something like that. They do seem to breathe pretty well with the venting around it and everything. Still, they're gonna fog up a lot faster than anything else, and that's, you know, really no surprise. So I wouldn't say that these should really be considered safety glasses. I would put them in a completely different category now that I've been using all of these for a while. The 3Ms with the foam, honestly, I can't even tell you where they are. I quit using them, and I must have misplaced them somewhere, and I wouldn't even, I'm not heartbroken about it because I'll never go back to them. I still have the colored lenses, and I use those every once in a while. But honestly, after wearing them for a long period of time, I don't like how when you take them off, everything just, you just get this blast of color change because they're you know, a colored lens, and they just kind of mess with your eyes, and I'm not a big fan of that. So these being as comfortable as they are, and you know, just all around a great pair of safety glasses, these are my new favorite, the Milwaukees. So if you want to pick up a pair of these or any of the others that I have in this video, those links will be below in the description. Those are my affiliate links, and any of those links that you use really help me out and help me make these videos for free. So thanks again for watching. I will see y'all in the next video.